Welcome to Charting Outcomes, Demographic Characteristics of Applicants in the Maine Residency Match and SOAP, a new interactive report published by the National Resident Matching Program. It is the first report to look at applicant demographic characteristics as they relate to specialty, match, and SOAP outcomes. This interactive report includes the demographic data of applicants, including sexual orientation, race and ethnicity, childhood urbanicity, and socioeconomic background, being the first generation in their families to graduate from college or medical school, and more. The aim of this video is to provide an overview of how to navigate through and use the many features of the report. Where should I start? We are excited that this report is interactive, allowing viewers to choose what information they are interested in seeing. The rest of this video aims to give you an overview of what is included in the report, suggestions for where to start, and some helpful tips for how to use the report. At the beginning of the report, you will see a table of contents screen. This is a great place to start because it lists all the report has to offer and serves as a home base for viewers when they are ready to explore new pieces of the report. You can return to the table of contents by clicking the home icon on any report screens. You may notice that the table of contents is divided into three sections: Maine Residency Match and SOAP, Maine Residency Match Active Applicants Only, and Narrative. If you have never used this report before, we recommend you review the options listed under the Narrative section before getting into the visuals. The helpful hints and definition screens will give you helpful tips on how to navigate through the report, as well as explanations of abbreviations and terminology you may not be familiar with. If you are interested in the background and methods used to create this report, we recommend reviewing the background and methods screens. Once you've gotten your bearings, it's time to get into the visuals. The visuals are listed under the other two sections of the table of contents based on what part of the match process the information is relevant to. For visuals that include information for all registrants, those who certified a rank order list and participated in the Maine residency match, and or those who participated in SOAP, the Supplemental Offer and Acceptance Program, you can refer to the Maine residency match and SOAP section. For visuals focused solely on active applicants, those who certified a rank order list and participated in the Maine residency match, you can refer to the Maine residency match active applicants only section. How do I interact with the visuals? The visual pieces of the report are where viewers can interact with the graphs on screen and choose what information they want to view. Each visual screen will have a set of drop-down menus that the viewers can use to slice and dice the data however they want. Paying attention to the drop-down menus included on each screen will be important for viewers to understand what information you are seeing. I'm going to give a quick overview of the different options, noting that each visual will have some combination of these. The Match Year drop-down menu lists each year demographic information was collected from applicants based on the year they participated in the match. For example, if I'm only interested in seeing the 2023 match year information, I would select only 2023 from the drop-down menu and the graphs would automatically update. The Applicant Type drop-down menu lists the six applicant types included in this report. Let's say I'm only interested in seeing the information for the two groups of senior applicants. I can deselect all other applicant types, and the graphs will update to show USMD and USDO seniors. The Program Type drop-down menu lists the five program types included in this report. Let's say I want to view the information for categorical programs only. I can deselect the other program types listed, and the graphs will update accordingly. If you would like more information on the different applicant or program types, visit the definition screen within the report. The report also includes three different sets of specialty drop-down menus: preferred, matched, and accepted specialty. Each set includes two drop-downs. First, a combined specialty group drop-down, which is used to include as many of the smaller specialties as possible by rolling smaller specialties up into the larger parent categories. When viewers select one of these parent categories, they can then select a specific specialty from the specialty dropdown. The specialty dropdown allows the viewer to drill down into specific specialties within a category. For example, if viewers only want to view internal medicine and not the combined specialties, they would select internal medicine and all combined specialties from the previous dropdown, then internal medicine under the specialty dropdown. Once a viewer selects from the specialty menu, the viewer must set this menu back to all to reset the combined specialty group menu to the full list of specialty options. While these three sets of drop-down menus function in the same way, it is important to know the difference between the three sets and to pay attention to which set is being used on each visual. Preferred specialty refers to the specialty of the program an applicant ranked first on their rank order list. Matched specialty refers to the specialty an applicant matched to. Not all applicants match to their preferred specialties. Accepted specialty refers to the specialty an applicant accepted a position in during the SOAP process. For more information on SOAP, please visit the NRMP website. Another cool feature of this interactive report is the ability to hover over each bar within the graph to view a tooltip. These tooltips give viewers more detailed information than what may be available on screen. Here are a few examples. Let's say I am interested in looking at sex assigned at birth for those who prefer family medicine and participated in match year 2023. When I hover over the bar for female, the tooltip shows that there were 2,329 females, which accounts for 58.2% of those who participated in the 2023 match and preferred family medicine. Next, let's say I want to look at race for those who prefer general surgery, and I am interested in preliminary programs specifically. When I hover over Black African American, we see that there are 47 applicants in this category, which accounts for 12.4% of those who prefer general surgery and a preliminary program type. Now let's say I'm interested in looking at the percentage of applicants reporting that they are a first-generation college graduate among those who prefer emergency medicine. We can see that 863 applicants reported being a first-generation college graduate, which is 18.3% of those who prefer emergency medicine. These tooltips will be extra helpful if you are viewing the report on a small screen, including a tablet or smartphone. Although all users will be able to view the report more easily in full-screen mode, we especially recommend that those of you who are using a smaller laptop or tablet view the report in full screen mode by clicking the full screen icon in the bottom right-hand corner. What should I do if I need help or have questions? The best sources of information to address questions or concerns are the written sections of the report, including the helpful hints, definitions, and background and method screens. If you still need help after reviewing these resources, you can email datarequest@nrmp.org and use the subject line Demographic Report Inquiry. Thanks for your interest in the Charting Outcomes, Demographic Characteristics of Applicants in the Main Residency Match and SOAP Report. We hope these data help advance understanding of and encourage discussion in the medical education community about relationships among the unique characteristics of applicants, the specialties they pursue, and their experience in the match.